During the celebrations of over 21 years of compassion internationally in partnership with Church of Uganda and Baptism Churches in Kasese, the beneficiaries lauded leaders for spearheading various development projects that have transformed their communities.
Some communities are not installed with clean water, and some children are not able to access education because they are not ready to raise funds, or they are needy in that they cannot be able to raise funds to fund their education. And most families have gotten children that suffer from serious diseases that really need to be attended to by
because we are living a life where we cannot afford the basic needs of life. That is starting right away from where I stay in a very small grass thatched house. It used to leak whenever it used to rain. Like that, the wolf sleeping in the house, there were no mattresses, used to sleep on rags, just like urban fibers. You know, life was not really, really good, it was so bad.
Leaders pointed out a number of achievements from the partnership.
The church, through their partnership with Compassion International Uganda, has extended not only services to the sponsored children, but even to the communities. I want to mention to each one of us that the Dasani principles of accessing clean water is becoming a reality through your support, and also provision of habitable places of residences have been constructed to the beneficiaries.
The result of this partnership also, all the four churches in partnership with Compassion have established active skills centers for the youth and children. Most of our participants have graduated with skills in operating computers, tailoring, bread and cake baking, soap making, blowing and drumming brass band equipment, male and female hairdressing, metal welding and pave making, among others.
Lenny Mugisha, the National Director, Compassion International, appealed to those who have reaped much from various programs to give back to communities.
When they came on the program, they came on to the program because they never had a voice. They were children who come from needy homes and their voice was constrained. But now they have a voice. So our appeal to them is, let them also become a voice to the voiceless. That is our appeal to those participants. Let them become a voice. Let them reach out, look out for a neighbor who needs to be defended, who needs to be protected. That is my appeal to the former participants.
Story compiled by Samuel Amanyide for the news.